in order to perpetuate himself in the society and in the institution, being fully aware of the fact that he was going to attain the age of superannuation and his secretaryship would also automatically come to an end. An attempt was made by him to get his age extended and on the strength of the same to continue as secretary of the society. After attaining the age of superannuation, principal of the institution is not at all entitled to continue as secretary. A specific mention has been made that petitioner number 2 was secretary by virtue of being principal, who happens to be an ex officio member, and once he attained the age of superannuation as principal, then he could be elected as secretary only when he was a valid member of the society, but at no point of time he had ever been enrolled as valid member of the general body of the society. The specific statement of fact has not been disputed in the rejoinder affidavit. Once this is the factual situational in respect of status of petitioner number 2 as principal of the institution has already attained the age of superannuation and this fact has not been sustained before this court as to in what way and manner he had been enrolled as member of the general body of the society, then legitimately petitioner number 2 has no grievance. The bishop, who had accepted the request to act as chairman along with petitioner number 2, has already washed his sin by resigning and submitting letter on 29 July 2010, regretting therein his deeds. These averments have been mentioned in paragraph 4 of the counter affidavit, and said specific averments have not at all been replied. It was also highlighted and demonstrated that there was no quorum in the meeting held on 28 May 2007 in which amendments had been carried out. It is seen that 4 officers and 5 members of the society were present in the meeting. 1 ex officio member and 4 members were absent, and there were total 14 members of the society. In the special general meeting held on 28 May 2007, only 9 members were present. Therefore, according to Rule 38 of the rules, at least 10 members were required to be present at the social general meeting held on 28 May 2007. In the absence of quorum laid down by Rule 38, neither the amendments could be passed in the special general meeting of the society, nor could be amendments made be registered by the assistant registrar. The above details, as noted in the order of the learned single judge, clearly show that there was no quorum in the meeting held on 28 May 2007 in which the amendments had been carried out. After saying so, the learned single judge correctly concluded that in such a situation and in this background, any interference with the order of the assistant registrar would amount to perpetuating the illegality and subscribing to apparent illegality committed.